This game is absolutely bonkers. A really tense back and forth affair. You have no idea who's actually going to win right up until the final moment. So it was played between Vasyl Ivanchuk with white, Alireza Firouzja with black, and it was part of their online Rapid and Blitz match, which they played in December 2020. So the full details of the match are below. Alireza has won the first two games. He's gone 2-0 up in the match. Ivanchuk has to strike back now. He's got white. What can he do here? So he kicks off with pawn to e4. We have e5 on the board. We go back into this Spanish variation after bishop b5, pawn a6. And after bishop a4, Alireza repeats pawn to d6. Now in the first game, Ivanchuk played an unusual way by taking on c6, the pawn recaptured, and the game went on with d4. But in this one, he plays in a more orthodox manner. He just castles the king. We had bishop to d7, and now he deviates slightly from main lines. You'd normally see things like pawn to c3 or maybe pawn d4, but he goes rook to e1 immediately before that pawn is even pressured by a knight, and therefore it gives Alireza an extra option here, which he duly takes. He loves to attack. So he goes pawn to g5 in this position. He loves to go down the g-file, and now Ivanchuk responds in a very principled way. So he goes pawn to d4. This is very principled, striking in the center when you're being attacked on the flank. Now Alireza goes g4, and you don't move the knight away, then you're dropping on d4, so instead Ivanchuk kicks on with pawn to d5. We had the knight retreating after it was attacked. The bishops exchanged off here, and now this knight ducked back to d2. And here Alireza just carries on attacking. He goes pawn to h5. Now we had c4 from Vasily, so he's going on the queen side. We've got that tense, exciting battle on our hands once again with the pawn storms. Now b6 was played by Alireza. This is a bit slow, a tiny bit passive. He should have really been looking at playing on the king side there with pawn h4 or f5, maybe bishop h6. b6 is a little slow and reactive to white, and Vasily gets a nice initiative now on the queen side. He goes knight c3. We had pawn a5, again responding to white, who's looking to play b4, although that was an important move to clamp on. And now here Vasily could go knight to f1. I do prefer this manoeuvre to what he played, because it's then looking to come into this f5 square or clamp down on that move. But what he does is knight back to b1 here. And his move is still good. We'll see his intention in a moment, but it's not quite as incisive. Now we had bishop to g7 developing. The knight came to a3, and pawn f5 comes from Alireza. So it's principled to strike at the center like this, try and break out your position. This was a backwards pawn, but after the captures here, knight recaptures, white does have access to this key e4 square now. And it's such a key square because it blockades this black pawn here, which then makes this bishop a bad bishop. So that's part of the strategic battle now. So the knight came to b5. This was Ivanchuk's whole idea of re-maneuvering this one, so that now this one's free to go to e4 rather than sitting on b5 itself. We had knight f6 from Alireza, and now he goes bishop g5. This is part of his strategic idea. So he wants to chop this bishop for knight and sit this one on e4 and say, my knight is better than your bishop. So Alireza responds. He goes knight h7, attacking the bishop, not allowing that plan. The knight comes to e4 anyway, and Vasily would be very happy with the captures here. Then this is coming into e6 soon. So Alireza didn't take on g5. He castled the king. We had the queen coming to d3 now, connecting the rooks. And this knight came into d4, so Alireza's looking for some counterplay there. And you don't want to be taking this. It is possible you keep advantage, but after the pawn recaptures, now this bishop could find a nice home on e5. The e-file is open and shared by both players. Nice position for black compared to what he gets in the game. So after knight d4, instead Vasily goes bishop to e3, just nudging that one back, putting a question to this knight. And best was to just retreat to f5 actually, because after takes, which Alireza played, pawn recaptures, Now there's another strategic problem in the position for black. Not just the knight on e4 dominating this bishop, but the backward c7 pawn, which can now be attacked and corralled with pieces down the c-file. So Alireza is all in on a kingside attack here. That's the challenge of his position. So queen f5 played, the rook came to the c-file here, rook f7 laterally defends the pawn. We had rook to c4, all very nice, preparing to triple pieces on this file. Now we had king h8, prophylaxis coming away from some of these checks perhaps in the future, and also looking to open the g8 square for the rook so that Alireza can try and attack soon. Now we had queen c2, and here Alireza pauses for about a minute and a half. They're getting down to about 3-4 minutes, and he comes up with rook g8. It's hard here for him to actually find good plans. Now you don't want to take here immediately as white, because after takes, queen takes, you're losing the knight at the end of the line. But what white can do here is play a beautiful sacrificial move. Can you find the best move in the position here? And if you're enjoying this video, do let me know by liking, commenting below, and consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't already. So here, the best move in the position is actually bishop takes on b6. A beautiful idea, because after the pawn recaptures, you lose the defense here, the knight can jump in. Now definitely don't take the queen on c2. This is actually a smothered checkmate, really beautiful. And if you retreat the queen like this, we can chop with check, queen recaptures. And although two minor pieces for a rook is usually a bad exchange, you'd prefer the two minor pieces, here it's actually good for white. After, say, rook d1, these pieces are just blasting down the files. There's a passed pawn here. This bishop's still dead. Really nice for white. So that would have been a better way to play after rook to g8. But instead, rook c1 was played, tripling on the file. Now we had pawn h4 trying to attack. Still, this bishop move was an option, but instead Chucky goes queen to e2. He gets a bit spooked, he's responding to Alireza's threats here. So bishop to f8 was now played by Alireza. He opens up this g line for the rook, and now Vasily had to go bishop to d2 here if he wants to keep some advantage in the position. This opens up the queen to protect the knight, and it also means that black can't play, say, bishop to e7. Now you can chop on c7. You can't go knight f6, or we can take. After, say, queen takes, we're picking up this pawn. If rook takes, we're picking up this pawn. These are the problems with the black position, not so easy to unravel. But after pawn to a4, which is what Vasily played, now bishop e7 is possible, because if you take this pawn, well, we pick up the knight here. It's not defended by the queen. So after bishop e7, here Vasily goes pawn to b4, we had captures here, the rook captures, and black is starting to unravel after knight to f6. This pressure here is gone, as we can see. You still can't take or you lose your knight. So he captures on f6, the bishop recaptured, and this rook came to the fourth rank here. Now it looks menacing, but so long as those pawns stay there, the rooks aren't actually coming into the game, and nor is the queen coming into these light squares. And now both players just start improving their pieces. Alireza brings his second rook to the g-file. This rook comes to e4. We had bishop to d8 holding this pawn, getting out of the way of the heavy pieces. This rook came to c4. And now you don't want to go g3 here. Again, you open up lines for the white pieces to actually attack your king. So instead, both players, they start shuffling. Grandmasters do this so well. So rook g6 played. The bishop came back to d2. Now we had queen d7. The bishop dropped into e1. And we can see that Chucky's just lost his advantage here from where he was earlier in the game. This rook came to the 7th. Now we had queen to d1, and both players are down to about 30 seconds each now. It's getting really tense. The king came to g8, the queen comes back to e2, and this is as good as a draw offer. If Alireza wants it, he can go king h8, take the repetition, but he loves to fight. So he goes king f7, really ambitious. And Chucky responds with ambition too. He goes pawn f3. Let's open that f-file. Now there's a threat to take this pawn and win it. So captures happened here. The queen took backward check. The king ducked to e8. This was with 2 seconds to go for Alireza, by the way, but they are getting 5 seconds a move, don't forget, increment. So after king e8, we had rook c2 played, holding this pawn here, trying to free up the queen, and now queen to f7 was a blunder by Alireza. So what Chucky should have done here is take the queen, after the king recaptured, let's say, or you can go with the rook, then you lose this pawn on h4 here. White's doing really well. But he didn't take the queen, he ducked away with queen to d3. And now best here for black was something like pawn to h3, or tripling the heavy pieces on the g-file with queen g8. But rook f6 was played, and this is a blunder because now you've left the protection of this pawn with the bishop. So the bishop captured here, Ivanchuk sees it, but the rook came to f3, a really tricky response from Alireza. So the queen is hit, you can't capture or you lose that one due to the pin. So instead we had the queen coming back to e2 here, the rook came away to a3, and there's some ideas to swing down here and start checking the king. And best here would have been something like queen to d1, holding the back rank, but also defending this pawn, or rook d2 does a similar thing. But instead we saw pawn h3, gives the king some luft, yes, but now that pawn was captured by Alireza, using the exact same tactic of this pin. So the bishop's attacked twice, best was queen c4, holding it like this, but we won't go down that route. Ivanchuk captures here, they're very low on time. The king recaptures, and now he follows up with this a5 move. Really tricky, will he push it into a passed pawn? Will he capture here? Well, the rook now came to g3, pressuring the king, and here Ivanchuk actually decided to take that one there. After recaptures, he goes queen c4, and this looks so scary for black. The whole idea is that you're coming down here. But queen f5, brilliant response from Alireza. He holds this c8 square. The rook holds the c7 square. White can't yet break through. So rook f2 played. Coming to the f-file, let's kick that queen, then we can start checking the black king. Rook f3 covers, still using that pinned pawn. The rook came back to c2. And now rook a3, once again looking to start checking from down here. So Vasily drops his rook back. Alireza comes back here, trying to defend his king. The queen invaded on c6 here, looking to take this pawn with check. But now the rook ducked back, it gives the pawn, but threatens a counterattack on this one. So now Vasily's all in on these checks. He takes on d6, the rook blocks the check, the queen took on b6, pinning this one, but here's what he'd missed. After queen takes on c2, he thought he had d6, winning back the piece, but actually then black has queen c5 check, forces the queens off, the rook recaptures, black is simply a rook ahead. So now Vasily is in trouble, he goes queen f6 check, he's looking for a perpetual, the king comes to c8, the players are on seconds, queen a6 check, king b8, and now Vasily's in trouble. If you check here, the rook blocks, there are no more checks. So after this move of king b8, his time's ticking down, and again he loses on time for the third game in a row. How is he coming back from a 3-0 deficit? Tune into the next game to find out. I hope you enjoyed this one. Click here if you want to see the Magnus Alireza Banter Blitz playlist. Thanks for watching, see you soon.